a long time to be cramped. I mean, these people that have been on the ship since Vancouver, 6 days in a cabin, you know, and you start to get irritated at each other, you know, because you've been crammed in a little space with somebody that you thought you loved. It's my wife, and after about 6 days, she'll go, why don't you go out and do something? Really getting irritated. That's the first part of the cruise. We're really polite to each other, aren't we? First part of the holiday. Like, my wife would be putting on her makeup, and I'm I go by. I go, excuse me, sweetheart. I have to go by. No, don't get up. I love you. After about 6 days, you go, get out of my way. I gotta go to the can. What are all these shoes doing here? How many pairs of shoes did you bring? She had one suitcase just for her shoes. I don't think she's alone on this. Ever had a silent fight on a ship? Because you don't want to fight out in public. You know, so my wife and I, for example, we'd be out at a reception. We'd be, I see her across the room. Now, apparently, I have done something wrong. I don't know what it is that I've done. But I see my wife across the room going like this. I'm going over there. I have my head ready to go over there. She wants to go down for a silent fight. Down to the cabin. It's not much of a fight, really. It's more like I stand there like this. Well, she's going. She knows people next door have a glass to the wall. Because we do that. Guys, do you ever find yourself watching your wife do something on the ship that you would never watch her do at home? You know, like my wife would be doing her nails, right? And I'm way across the cabin, you know, 4 feet away. I'm watching her do her nails. She goes, what are you doing? I seem to be watching you do your nails at some point in my existence. You've never done that before. Never gone this long without cable television before. I look forward to time around the world. Report from the bridge. But there isn't a guy who hasn't done this on a cruise. After about 4 or 5 days, you're on a tour, you've been out on tour and stuff. And after about a week or so, the man has to select an article of clothing to wear to the Lido for breakfast. Golf shirt, t-shirt. So the man goes over to his closet. Pardon me, the man goes over to that section of the closet. That he has been assigned. The three little hangers on the left-hand side. One hanger that has all his shirts. A hanger next to it with all his pants. And a third little hanger with everything else. So the man opens up the closet door, and he very carefully moves his wife's clothes over. He grabs a shirt. Now, the first thing the guy does is inspect the shirt. Then he does this. I can get another day out of that one. It's not that bad. Going to see most of these people again anyway. Here, honey, smell this for me. Would you? After about 5 days, I start to drive my wife crazy with this. She goes, do you have to do that in here?
Sorry, sweetheart.
If you're really sorry, you wouldn't do that. If I didn't do that, I might explode. I have the dog to blame at home.
It's horrible. What have you been eating?
Everything.
Why don't you light a match?
I'm kind of afraid to light a match. I might blow those little windows right out of this place.
Why don't you go out in the hallway and do that?
I did go out in the hallway. Captain Stewart sent me back in there.